Hey guys, this is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and we're visiting a customer of ours about a 2-ton-per-hour turnkey system, and we're gonna help him tune it in a little bit and get it set up and running as optimally as possible. So here's their 8x12 jaw crusher module. They have a little ramp up to the hopper. They can take a wheelbarrow and dump it in the crusher hopper. Goes down through the crusher into the conveyor module. And then these guys are working on getting the hammer mill ready to change the hammers. And then down onto our 5x12 shaker table. They have a couple of sluice boxes, the port of the number 3 and the number 4, just to check for gold lost. The tailings number 4 port going to the spiral classifier, where they classify the oversized tailings. And then the fine tailings out of the spiral classifier go down this trench into the first tailings pond, and there's a little pass through where the clean water siphoned off, and I believe they pump water out of the second pond there. Here's their stockpile of ore. They're getting ready to feed into the jaw crusher. And they're surface mining with an excavator, and then the guys hand pick into these sacks, and they bring it here to stage it for the crusher. But this is the kind of ore they're working with. Quartz veins hosted in an argillite. And the grade of this stuff is about an ounce a ton, they tell me. But they've gotten samples as high as 10 ounces a ton. Here's what powers the whole mill. This is a Caterpillar generator, 100 kilowatt. And they've got the main power running up to a pole, across a couple of poles down to the mill. These guys were able to crush a full hopper or the conveyor module in about 25 minutes of runtime with the jaw crusher. And the conveyor module hopper can hold about 1 cubic yard, but they overfill the hopper. And so in this situation, it's probably holding somewhere between 2 and 2.5 tons. And so when the hopper was full, they would shut the jaw crusher off. And then it took the hammer mill about an hour to process the hopper. So the jaw crusher was only running part of the time for this operation. One of the things that was very unique about this mine is their gold is very, very coarse. And so unlike most mines that want to crush as fine as possible, these guys actually had a screen that was fairly large. And so in some of the shaker table videos, you may be able to see some larger pieces on the shaker table. And the reason they wanted to crush the material fairly large is so that the gold didn't hang up in the hammer mill and get over-processed or grind up. And so these guys' goal is to process the tailings through a spiral classifier, as you can see here, auger out the oversized quartz, and then recrush at a later date to liberate more gold. But because a lot of their gold is so coarse, they have to do a coarse crush and concentrate first, and then they can come back later and capture the fine gold once it's recrushed again through the hammer mill with a finer screen. And here you can clearly see the large quartz pieces on the shaker table. But again, when we look into the number one trough here, you can see the large pieces of gold that they want to get out of the grinding system as soon as possible. So here's some gold from our cleanup from last night. And we ran about 2 tons, and this is probably half of the gold. They're cleaning up the rest here now. But you can see the gold is very, very coarse, very big pieces, and hardly any fine gold. It's just mostly big pieces of gold, and this ore has very little sulfides, so it's mostly just quartz and big gold, which is pretty unique. Okay. And so here's where they're mining, kind of a open pit style. They're digging with an excavator down and exposing the veins in the surface. And then it looks like they're hand sorting the ore out into bags and bringing it up to the mill. And here's one of these veins these guys have exposed. Running up here, it's all muddy. But you can see here there's a little fresh break. There's a little quartz vein there. And these veins are running about 1 ounce a ton. And they're hosted in this kind of argillite slate type of material. Here's a view of the wall rock, or the country rock. And so they dig off the overburden down to the vein, expose the vein, and then they bring it out in these bags here. And so in here is all their good hand-sorted ore. And they'll take that up to the mill. These are hammers in a 24 by 16 hammer mill. And we've run about 6 or 7 tons of very, very hard quartz through them. And the front leading edge is wearing. The face of the hammer is still visible. And we have a little bit more wear on the outside hammers than on the inside hammers. And so my recommendation is to run another 6 or 8 tons and then check the hammers again. And if they need to be flipped or turned around, then you can use this leading edge to crush another maybe 10 or 15 tons of rock. But the rock here is very, very hard, and even the 20% chrome hammers are wearing quickly. So they're only gonna get about 30 tons per set of hammer. Whereas we have customers in Utah who are actually getting over 100 tons on a set of hammers. So it really varies. The wear rate really varies depending on the type of ore and the hardness of the ore.
How's the screen look?
Yeah, the screen still looks good.
Yeah.
It's wearing a little bit on the middle, but that's to be expected. So now they're cleaning up their number one and number two concentrates on the table again. And all the quartz is flowing down here into the number three. And they're putting their concentrates up on the shaker table. And I don't know if I can get the camera to focus while it's shaking. But the gold line comes right down here under the water bar. So you dried the concentrates?
Mm-hmm.
so it doesn't bother me at all. Huh.
And then you're going to put them in that little jar?
Yeah.
Okay. Can I watch? Let's see how you do. I want to see. And this is the dried concentrates from the first 2 tons we ran, right? Yeah?
Okay.
And so there you go. There's the cons from the first 2 tons.
That's it. There it is. Cool.
Alright.
And for the first 3 or 4 hours we were here, we got the mill tuned up, and now it's running the 2 or 2.5 tons per hour, and they're getting some good gold off their shaker table. So the customer's real happy, and they're running even into the darkness tonight. So hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.